Welcome back, folks, to another episode. We've got a very exciting episode for you today, but before today's video starts, I gotta say a huge shout out to Cove for sponsoring today's video. This right here is my new Cove speaker. I've been using it for quite some time now. This thing is the most unique speaker I've seen on the market. Now to you guys, this looks like a just ordinary speaker, but it has a really unique feature that I've never seen before. You could have one speaker just like this, 360 sound. I really like using this thing when I've got people over, friends, family, whatever it might be, when I'm playing in a big area like this shop or inside, like the house, the basement, outside, whatever it might be. But the best thing about this thing splits into two speakers. You have a left and a right. Look at this. So you can separate them in the room, you can bring it back together, you can play them, and this thing is freaking loud. So it's as easy as connecting your phone to the speaker via Bluetooth, and take a listen. As you guys could hear, it is super loud. I can usually run this thing on a single charge. It's up to 7 hours. Like I said, you break it off into two. You can set them in separate rooms, different areas in the rooms. That way the whole party is bumping. This thing is also water resistant and has a built-in microphone up to 30 feet. If you guys want one of these, it will be linked down below. And you can save up to 64% off of this right here for this month only. Link down below if you guys want to go check it out. This is the newest, latest, and greatest speaker I have ever seen. So again, if you guys want this, it will be linked down below, 64% off for this month only. Click the link down below, go check it out. Look at this. Absolutely insane. Never seen anything like it. It is brands like Cove that I partner up with that allow me to do what I do every single day. So huge shout out to Cove for sponsoring today's video, and you guys enjoy.
Shoo! What's going on, folks? Welcome back to another episode. Carol, why are you just laying down there, buddy? Pigs. Oh, no, hey, no, don't get Hennifer. Hey, loose, no. Hennifer, why are you out? They're gonna get you, Hennifer. Hennifer, oh God, oh rip. Oh rip to Hennifer, oh rip. Okay, all right, hang on.
All right, we're good, Millie. Calm down, loose, calm down. We got Hennifer on the other side of the pen here. Can't be losing Hennifer out here. Anyways, welcome back to another episode. Starting the day off down here by the animals. Got to get everybody fed. You can tell the pigs are hungry. I like the pigs, but this like constant growl squeal, like you guys can hear it right now. Like, not gonna lie, it's kind of annoying. If they just like tone it down a little bit, it would be appreciated. But anyways, better give these guys some food so they calm down. Hang on, llama. We gotta get all these guys taken care of first.
Oh God, someone moved the trough.
Yeet!
Oh, close enough. I'm coming, llama. Hang on, right here.
Hey, right here. There's a little bit.
We need to get two grain bins. We need one for down here since now all the animals, it's like they split up half and half. Half of them over there, half of them over here. This is a long walk. Or I could just be smart and pick it up and set it in between the two. I'm starting to use my brain here. Slowly but surely, my intelligence is coming back here. There you go, Carol.
There you go, buddy.
Llama, right here.
Right here, llama.
There you go.
Steve, right here, Steve.
Steve.
Steve, come here, Steve.
Hey, come get some grain, Steve.
Steve just enjoys watching llama. Oh, wait, Steve, there you go, Steve. Get it, Steve, come on, there you go. Steve figured it out, llama. No, Karen, go back to yours. All right, well, I might as well just finish off the rest of this grain. There's not a ton left. Here you go, Carol. You want some right here, buddy?
There you go. All for you, buddy. It's all for you, not for nobody else, Carol.
How you been, Carol? You're looking good. The flies are pretty much staying off. You see a couple of them, but they're not bothering her too bad, huh, buddy? How you doing, Felicia? Felicia. Hey, Felicia, go. Here, Felicia, I'll give you some over here.
Right here, buddy.
Yeah. Yeah. There you go. There you go, Felicia.
Carlos, what up, buddy?
Here, you want a little bit more? Here. There you go, birdies. For all the chickens and guineas and everybody. Sheep, your wool's growing back. You guys are looking freaking thick. Look at that little ass over there. How's it going, little buddy? You hanging out? If you guys missed it, a few videos back, I don't know how long ago it was, but we let them together, basically, because we separated the donkeys when the baby was born at first, and then put them together. Now they're doing great. I always see the baby and Carlos hanging out together, which is good. So, Carlos, how you doing there, buddy? You hanging in there? You doing horse things? That's good. I'm glad to hear it. Anyways, look at all these animals. They're doing fantastic. Everybody, it works out good that we've got some over there. I wish like two more of these guys would go on that side. It just makes the feeding process a little bit easier. But I should give Chungus some food here too. I'm sure Chungus is hungry.
Chungus, what up, buddy?
How you doing?
What you doing, little guy? Oh, come back. Everybody misses you. Come here, Chungy. Yeah, oh yeah, see, you want that grain. See, I got Chungus on grain duty. You want some grain, buddy? All right, hang on.
You should leave Chungus alone. Look at her. She's like, oh my God, my beloved Chungus. I just want to bite you. Chungus, don't worry, I will protect.
Here you go, Chungus. Bony apple feet, son. Oh, yeah. Love you some of that grain, don't you, buddy?
Millie, not for you, pal. Well, animals are taken care of. Millie, stay out. And they're chilling. The quail, I don't really film much of the quail. They're just, I mean, they're freaking quail. What are they gonna do? They ain't gonna do nothing. So they're chilling. We have lost a few from either accident letting them out, or I've just seen a couple of them have just died in there. It just kind of happens, natural causes. I think we still should have, you know, 40, 50 of them left that are, they're pretty much full grown now. So we should be, hopefully, I can't decide what to do with them. I can't decide, do I want to just release them all and hope that they reproduce and I have quail hunting and maybe every year I raise them and release them, raise them, release them for hunting? Or do I strategically release them a few at a time for certain training sessions for Lucy? Like, do we make it a thing where, like, you know, how I practice the duck hunting retrieving with hers, I take her duck hunting. So maybe that's what I do with her with the quail. And I just go out and, you know, find a nice big thick patch of grass somewhere up by my house or in the backyard and plant a couple of them. You know, maybe like two at a time or something, and then use that to train her. So have her walk with me, whether it's on a leash or if I can get her to kind of stay next to me and see if she'll flush. She's not a pointer, okay? She's a lab. So what they do is they're called flushing dogs. So what they do is they find the bird and they scare the bird and you shoot it and then they retrieve it. So I would think if I like planted a couple, I'm pretty sure she could find them, especially if, I mean, I would know where they are so I could kind of guide her a little bit. The only downside is like I would actually be hunting them, meaning like I would shoot them and they would die, which would be fine for a couple times, but I don't really want to like shoot all my quail. Like, I didn't spend 6 months raising them just to kill them all. Like, that doesn't really make much sense. Granted, they do taste freaking delicious, but I have heard of this thing called like a callback box. I think I've talked about this before. If any of you guys know anything about it, let me know. But basically, like, you can release all your quail and use them for hunting and shoot a couple, right? But if you know, if you want them all to come back, you like put one of them in a box and then like it calls to them at night and then they all come back together. And then like, then you just like put them back in there and then they live. And then like when you need to take them out for hunting, you can release them, which there's not, if no matter what, if you're shooting them and then she's retrieving them, like, that doesn't really do you much good. Why don't you just take two out at a time, right? So I think what I'm gonna do is just take, I mean, she's obviously just, she gets pissed at these things, but I think what I'm gonna do is, instead of releasing all of them at least right now, take them out one or two at a time, couple times a week, and do some training sessions with her. And then, I mean, I don't really want to take care of them throughout the winter. It doesn't really do any good. These are bobwhites, which are like the wild species of the quail, which is what you would find, like, if I were to go walk over on my neighbor's property and see quail, they'd probably be bobwhites. So I feel like releasing them would be good, but like I've also talked to biologists and game warden and they're like, dude, you're basically wasting your time if you think they're gonna reproduce and then you're gonna shoot them next year. Like, they pretty much get ka-chowed by coyotes and raccoons. Like, their survival rate is like nothing because they were raised in a pen. They weren't really raised to fend for themselves and to go find food and be wild. So comment down below, what do you guys want me to do? Do you want me to take them out a couple at a time, train Lucy, and just dwindle down the population, and then maybe at the end of the season I just release them and feed the coyotes and raccoons, and if some of them make it, great. If not, it's no big deal. Do you think I should try to just release them all and then try getting them to come back? Which I don't see like a huge advantage, because like in order to train Lucy, I'm gonna have to shoot them. She's gonna have to see it fall and then she's gonna have to retrieve them. I mean, that's what hunting is. So no matter what, you're gonna shoot them. So I feel like just taking them a couple at a time would make the most sense. Or I just take a few at a time, work with her, and then keep them alive throughout the winter and do it again next year. What do you guys wanna see me do with the quail? I'll go with whatever you guys tell me to do, whatever you think is best. But today's episode is not about quail. And it's not about feeding my beloved animals, even though they're amazing and they're chill. Especially Carol. Carol, you're cute, Carol. Look at her. Have any of you guys ever seen a better looking cow than that? I don't think so. She is the best looking cow out there. Anyway, it is about deer prep. Deer season. Okay. Now, some of you guys, especially expert deer hunters, by the way, I'm just going to give you a quick little rundown of my experience with deer. Pretty much zero. I shot one last year at the farm with a rifle because I was sitting in a blind and I walked out at sunset and saw a bunch in the field and shot with three and it was a doe. That's literally the extent of my deer hunting experience. Now, I've been putting a lot of trail cameras out. We've put feed out, not recently, but like throughout the summer and stuff in spring. We put some feed out and haven't seen any big bucks, not going to lie. Last year, we saw a few, but I didn't hunt the backyard last year. Did not deer hunt backyard whatsoever last year. Only did the farm. This year's my first year hunting in the backyard at my house. And so I did set out a bunch of trail cameras and let them rip for like a week or two. And so I'm gonna run up and review that footage before I do anything. And what I did was I placed them mainly on those new trails. If you remember the new trails that we made for the cabin, right? To go over there. Well, deer are lazy. I mean, like most animals or humans, like they're gonna take the path that's easiest to travel. So instead of them walking through the thicket, they're gonna walk down the perfectly mowed trail. Now, a big buck might be a little skittish, but like, you know, there's no pressure around here. No one around me deer hunts. So like, these deer don't even know what a rifle is or a bow is or anything like that. So I set out a bunch of trail cameras. I am gonna go up and check them, see what we've got, see if there's any bucks, see if there's any does at all. So I'll show you later where I put the trail cameras. I basically, like I said, I put them along the trail. I did find a couple oak trees, which drop acorns, which I know deer like. So I'm hoping that in and of itself attracted them to the area, as well as just making a new path, because I know the deer live up in the thick stuff where I put all the new paths. So I assume they're gonna travel. So I put 4 trail cameras out there scattered throughout. So I'm gonna go up and look at them. And then depending on what I see and where I see and how I see it, if that makes any sense, I've got these guys. We have 2 of them. There's 3-person clear view mesh deer blinds. Actually, I bought at the auction. I think that was during the Pew Pew auction. And then I've got some chainsaws and some T-post hammers and a bunch of trail cameras. We've got 7 cell cameras right there. So I went from just the traditional camera where you gotta go grab the SD card to view the footage. I'm going all the cell cameras because we're getting so close to deer season. I don't wanna be going in there and scaring them. You know, potentially there's a buck right next to where I put one of these blinds. I go to check a camera and the buck leaves for good. You don't want that. So I'm going all to Moultrie cell cams today. So I'm gonna place 7 of them, and I'm not only gonna place them where I'm planning on hunting. Like, back here is some really good timber, really good timber. I have no trail cameras back there. I have no stands back there. I've got nothing, but I'm gonna go down there and I'm gonna look for a deer path, a currently used deer path, and set up a camera here. Basically, I'm gonna take these 7 cameras and spread them through my property. Instead of focusing, like, the 4 that I have out right now that I haven't looked at the footage, I put in one specific location to figure out what is there at this moment. What direction are they traveling? Where are they coming from? So I put 4 cameras in a really dense area, not super dense, but maybe a quarter mile radius area. But now I'm gonna take the 7 cameras and spread them across all 80 acres in all different areas, different quadrants in the backyard, figure out where the big bucks are, if there are any, where they're coming from and stuff like that. So that's enough blabbering. Let's head up to the shop and check the trail cameras to see what we're dangling with, and then pick out a couple spots for these blinds, get them placed, get them brushed in, ready for deer season. You guys stay tuned.
Alrighty, folks, how's it going? This is the official game cam review. See it now, the old riding lawnmower. I dumped all of the cards on a hard drive and labeled them. That way I would know where they're at while I'm reviewing the footage. So I took it, put it in my computer, labeled where it was, and so that was Lucy. Lucy, really? Is this necessary? What I'm saying is I put it on a hard drive and then I label it so that way when I'm talking, I can describe where the location is. That way I know while I'm reviewing the footage where exactly is I'm talking about. Why the 2 dogs had to join me on this adventure, I'm not exactly sure, but let's go ahead and log in here and pull up the footy. Let's see what we're dangling. So we had 4 cameras, like I said, and Millie, you know what would be sick is if you just like didn't come up here. And you too, Lucy. Like, it'd be sick if you guys just went and lay down like anywhere else. Like anywhere on the property, anywhere in the, like literally anywhere but here would be freaking sweet. All right, dope. They're not moving. Sick. Okay, so let's go ahead, hit that screen record button so that way you guys at home can see exactly what we're talking about here. Millie, you comfy? You comfy, buddy? I'm glad. I'm glad you are. That makes one of us. That's awesome. All right, let's start with camera number 1. Oh, look at that. Literally, the first picture is a town. Turkey. Millie, are we gonna be, there is a fall turkey season here, so that's a good sign. So first picture, we got a turkey. Look at that beard on Buddy, though. Sheesh. So in the fall, where I live, you can shoot a hen or a male or a female. I don't know why I word it that way. A male or a female, a tom or a hen. You can shoot either one. This is a big freaking turkey. I mean, a long beard. Look at that beard, dude. That's big. That's all dangle. Okay. Look at the coyote right there. We got Wile E. Coyote. He's ripping. Okay. Nothing. That might be the coyote again. I don't know what that is. Oh, that's the coyote. Look at those ears. I don't know what that is. The one thing that's funny about trail cameras, freaking looks like UFOs all the time. It kind of, that must be that coyote. Look at that guy. He's just chilling. Oh, that looks like another coyote. That's a daylight guy. Yep, look at that. Old coyote. He's just strolling through. So this trail camera is fairly close to the original cabin building spot. That first pad area that I was like, cabin's going here, and then I changed my mind. So it's like right when you start heading up the hill there. So that means there's coyotes kind of down where we're gonna put the cabin, which would be kind of cool. Oh, there's deer, thank God. I thought I only had turkeys and coyotes out here. So it looks like two does. That's a pretty good size. Oh, look, mom, that's a mom and baby. You know, I'm not a big deer hunter, so like honestly, I don't care if I shoot a doe, but if it's with a baby, I don't think I could do it. I don't. Oh, there's another one. That's a different one. That's behind that one. So two does, and we can call it a fawn. Or is that another fawn? Wait, hang on, back up. I don't think that was the same, because they went the same direction. Oh, there's another doe. Okay. Is the baby? Oh, no. Oh, turkeys. I can't see with the glare. The turkeys. Oh my God, look how many there are. Holy smokes. All right, so I might be doing some fall turkey hunting. I mean, oh, what was that? What is that? Why is this glare? I put the cameras facing the freaking east, not the strat. I can't tell if that's a coyote or a fox. What is that? That looks, kind of looks like a goat, honestly. It's got that tail with the long hair. Oh, it's a dog. Oh no. There's the coyote again. So are the coyote and the dog hanging out? There's nothing. There's the dog. Whose dog is that? I'll have to text my neighbors. It doesn't have a collar on. Look at it, it's following that coyote. It looks like a little hound dog of some kind. He's back again. Rick, what are you doing? The one thing that's not good about this is if it's like one of my neighbor's pets and I put out a coyote trap, like that's not gonna be good for Buddy here. So I'll text my neighbors here. I don't think any of my neighbors have it. Oh, there looks another coyote. Yeah, another coyote. Another coyote, yeah. Another coyote, yeah. Okay, all right, yep, another coyote. I wonder what's in that area. Like, look, coyotes, dogs, everything is just hanging out. Oh, there's another deer. Okay. Oh, wait, that might've been the baby. That might be the baby there. And that might be the mom. So it looks like they're eating the acorns. So like I said, there's oak trees all in this area, and they started dropping their acorns now that it's the fall. So like, I'll show you guys when we go to set up blinds, there's acorns all over the ground. So I'm assuming that that's what they're eating. That's why I put the cameras up there as well, because I figured like deer like acorns. So I don't think, well, there's a rabbit. Look at that little guy. I don't think coyotes eat acorns. I feel like they might just be there because all these other animals are running through their incentive. I'm not really sure. There's another deer, okay, yeah. Squirrel, see, squirrels love nuts. They're big fans of the old nuts right here. That's literally the next picture. Look at that. Yeet. That's weird. All right, squirrel. The squirrel season's also open. Millie, remember when Millie and I went squirrel hunting last year? I mean, basically, I went hunting and took Millie with me just for moral support, but we got one. So, I mean, if you guys want to see a squirrel hunt, there's obviously some squirrels here eating these acorns, which would be a really easy spot. I mean, I feel like I just sit in one of these blinds in the afternoon. I feel like he'd be ripping around. All right, it's nighttime again. Something's on the right. Oh, raccoon. Look at him. He's hauling ass. That raccoon. Dude, there's so many pictures. Is that another raccoon? Looks like another raccoon. Okay, daytime. We got another deer. So we've got some pretty regular. Okay, so those look like two full grooms. Look at those guys. Ooh, look at that. Ooh, what is that black thing on its arm? Yee. Hey, buddy, how you doing? Look at them. They're just hanging out. So I think the combination of the acorn trees. Look, Lucy, don't run into the camera. This is important. I think the combination of the acorn trees and the skinny new trail. I mean, this new trail is only 6-7 feet wide, as wide as a skid loader. So like, it's really going to funnel the deer. So that's why I feel like we're getting so many. Oh, that looks like a baby. So we're getting so many pictures of deer. Oh, was that that's a buck. First buck, baby. That's a little guy. That's a 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's a little guy though. Like what, skinny frame. Hey buddy, I wanna see another picture of your rack. There it is. That's a decent picture. I'm not a big deer hunter, okay? But if I'm gonna shoot a buck, I mean, that guy looks like he has potential. You guys comment down below. Does this guy have potential or not? Would you pass on this guy or would you shoot him? My gut is telling me, now you get a better, look at that guy's nuts. You get a better idea. That's a pretty small rack. I feel like that's a pass. Honestly, I have more ambition to shoot a doe than this guy, because this guy in a couple years might be a big trophy buck, and a doe is obviously gonna make babies, but it's, you're not taking away, like this guy's what? I don't know, 3 or 4 years old probably. Comment down below, what do you guys think? Oh, he's got Mamacita with him. All right, okay. Oh, there's another one. Oh, freaking coyotes, dude. Look at these guys. And more turkeys, look at that. So we got three, that front one looks like it's got a beard on it. Look at these guys. Wow, that's crazy how many there are. All right, so that's the end of one. Hopefully this video is not too long. The next three cameras, I'm just gonna rip through instead of commentating the entire thing, because you guys are gonna literally be here forever. All right, picture number one, looks like we already got a doe and a baby, maybe? All right, like I said, I can't commentate this. This video will be forever. So let's just go through them. Looks like we got squirrels. I'll just stop you guys if anything crazy happens. Squirrels. Oh, what was that? Oh, I can't. Oh, it looks like that dog. Bottom left corner. Looks like it might be that dog. Okay, so let's keep going. So I'm gonna rip through these fast. I just realized how long it's gonna take me to go through all these. Oh, there's another deer. Looks like a doe. Looks like another doe. So this, oh, there's another doe. So this camera is to the east, closer to my house. It's not up in that corner where that cabin's gonna be. This is like, you done? This is like closer to my house, maybe like 500-600 yards. I mean, I don't know, a quarter mile or so. Lucy, can we chill with the background noise, buddy? Like I was saying, this camera, it's closer to more open pasture and stuff, just basically on the other side of the hill behind my house. So it looks like we got more does. Does. Squirrels, does. More squirrels. Does. Squirrels. Does. Oh, that might be a buck. That's the only pick it came up with, but see on the left side, that might be a rack. It looks like a, oh snap, and it don't look like the same one. That's the only one it has though. It's the only picture it snapped. I didn't set this one up at the right angle either. I set it directly perpendicular to a path. You want to set it down a path so it catches them coming and going. And that's it for camera number two. More deer, potentially one buck. All right, so this camera I set directly beneath the big oak tree, one of the big oak trees I see. So looks like we got a doe out the gate, walking by. Yeah, just keep going, okay. Oh, what up, Ricky? Look at that guy. See, I'm not good at trail camera angles. It's pointed up too much, I feel like. I can't even, what is that? It looks like a deer. It kind of looks like a, oh yeah, that's a deer. I don't see any antlers. Well, that's all I got. Not much on that camera. So that was right below the oak tree, but I think I messed up on the angles of that one. That was the reasoning for lack of pictures. Last camera, here we go. Oh snap, looks like we got a buck out the gate, folks. It looks like the same one though. It looks like that, what was it, a 7-pointer? So this is up high. So if you are at where we're building the cabin and climb straight up that big trail that we made, this is like at the top of that. So if anything on the top area wants to go down to that new pond, the cabin build area, this is the first camera that sees them. So looks like a small buck and a squirrel. Oh. And a doe. A lot of these are probably the same deer because I put these cameras. Oh, there's Ricky. What are you doing, Rick? And there's coyote. A lot of these coyotes, raccoons, everything, squirrels. Oh snap. Look at these guys. They're fighting. They're freaking pissed. Look at that coyote. Broad daylight, dude. This is crazy. Is he chasing that squirrel? No, maybe not. A lot of these animals are going to be the same. I'm going through these quick. They're probably the same bucks, the same does. Oh, there's Bucky again. Yep, that's the same one. So that's the old 7-pointer. Because I set them along the trail, mainly, again, to make sure I really captured what was there, how frequent they're coming. I mean, this is a daily thing. As many pictures as these have, they're moving every single day and every single night down this path. So if my goal is to shoot one of these does, I think I can get it done. I would really hope that I don't get the one with the baby, though, because I'd feel a little bit bad about that. But come rut, the bucks might be chasing these does. So the fact that I have got native does who live here, that squirrel's just killing it. It's a good thing because it's gonna, oh, we got more turkeys. Probably the same bunch. Yeah, probably the same bunch because it's just basically down that trail. Oh, that's it. All right, folks. Well, that is what is on the trail cameras. Let's go ahead and head out, set up more cameras, and find places to put the blinds. Stay tuned.
Shoo! All right, folks, we made it out. Well, this is where the cameras were at. And actually, I made the mistake. The camera that I said was close to the top was the one that's on the bottom. I flip-flopped those two on accident because I'm looking at the backdrop. And this one doesn't have any cedars laying down, and the top one does. I thought it was the other way around. So you guys might have been wondering, why were there so many coyotes? Look at this. I don't even know what this is. What kind of bird? Let me know what you guys think. I mean, it looks like a crow. What are the odds? Look at the camera. What are the odds, though? Like, what are the odds I set this camera up and then the coyotes would eat something here? That's why you saw so many coyotes, like the two that you saw fighting and everything like that. I kept wondering, I'm like, you know, I understand coyotes passing, but they kept hanging out here. And I made the comment, I don't think they like the acorns that the oak trees are dropping. There's no actual oak trees right here. The oak trees are actually right over there. But that's like the most bizarre thing ever. What are the odds? Literally, like, I'm not making this up. I'm not lying. I didn't plant this here. What is this, Mel? What do you think that is? It looks like some type of, I don't know, it's dark feather. Lucy, what do you think that is, buddy? I don't know. You have to comment down below. It looks kind of like a crow or something. So that was one camera. camera. This was the camera that had, I think this was the one that had a bunch of the action. I think, I can't keep them straight of like which one was which. I mean, most of the time you saw the same bird, the same animal on all the cameras because they are so close together. So working up this hill, this is where these oak trees are, these big oak trees. So right now, oh God, I just got freaking stung by something. Right now, I am looking for potential blind locations. Now I will not be bow hunting, okay? So for those of you guys that are new, I cannot shoot a bow. Like physically, I can shoot a bow fishing bow, but anything with some really strong pullback, whatever you call that, it messes up my shoulder. And it's not that I like physically can't. I physically can. It's after the fact. My shoulders hurt really bad. And I always thought, oh, it's just because my muscles aren't used to it. And I went to the doctor and there's some big long term for it, but essentially like I don't have bone formed where I need to have bone and it's just cartilage. We took x-rays and my shoulders are basically just toast. So for those of you wondering, Flair, why are you going to be shooting with pews and not a bow? That is why. Now, crossbows are also an option. So I might dabble with that. But for the backyard, I'm planning on using pews. So I gotta find a spot that isn't super close quarters. Like this is, if a deer comes down here and I'm here, I mean, that's not too bad. But I've got to find a spot where I can set up and see a lot because I'm going to be using a pew. But at the same time, I don't want to be, you know, not where the deer are because this is obviously where the deer are going to be. So I'm just going to walk up here. Yep. So here's those acorns, Millie. No, you don't like the acorns. There's the start. No, really? You want an acorn? Oh, you got burrs on your face? Look at all these burrs. Get those burrs off of you. So here's where the acorns, right here, big oak tree that drops these things. They're everywhere, literally hundreds. So I always thought this would be a really good spot because I know deer like acorns, squirrels like acorns. And this is the path that we cleared. So this was all dense forest a month and a half ago. So we came out and cleared it. And so I'm trying to find a good spot for one blind. Yeah, look at these acorn shells everywhere. This tree is just dropping them like crazy. So I know the deer are going to be here. Whether they're does or buck, there's no telling. I'm looking for deer poop right now. I don't see any. The amount of shells though. Well, that's a full one, but shells. So I know they've already been down here. Whether it's squirrels or deer. It'd be a really good spot for a tree stand. That tree would be, because all the deer are gonna be coming down there, over here, or from down there. But this is another camera. So when I said this one was attached to the oak tree, it wasn't attached to it, it was attached next to it, but that was another camera right there. So I'm trying to figure out, I originally thought maybe over here, it wouldn't be that bad of a spot. If I put it up against this and took these brush and placed it right here, you would basically see this. See, that's, I would have to cut this tree limb down. So that way I could shoot the deer when they start walking down there. You could shoot them if they take this other path. But I mean, that's a close shot. If I'm here to there, that's probably a 20 yard rifle shot. I feel like that doesn't make any sense. This is a really good bow spot, not a pew spot. So I don't know. I can't decide how close, because how close do I want them? I mean, I know you, the closer the better, but the closer they are, the better chances are that they're gonna find you. So if I'm sitting here and I take out these branches so I can see, basically gotta sit here, I could shoot them as they come down this lane to come grab these acorns. Again, if they take the other path, or if I see any back in that thicket, or if they come up from there. But I mean, that's a close shot. I don't know. You deer experts are probably gonna cringe if I put a ground blind right here being this close. I feel like this isn't, but there's no other good spots for this spot. Now I want to go up there and I want to put the second blind way up there, up top, up high, but I can't decide. Is it worth it to stick a blind here? I don't know what that is. Must be a bird. I kind of want a squirrel hunt over here too, not gonna lie. So it wouldn't be bad to have a blind because I thought that'd be such a nice spot for a blind. You're not gonna get the distance. The deer are gonna be right there up in your face, which is a good thing for bow hunters. Rifle, I feel like being on the ground and stuff like that, it's probably not that great. So anyways, I think I'm gonna run up there and find my other spot first. And then depending on how close I put that to this area, will determine if I put it here or maybe I put it down there. Or maybe I go on the other side of my property and put it. So anyways, I just wasted like 10 minutes of your guys' time, but just had to show you guys. This is the juice. This is where the deer are gonna be because it's so thick. This is the only cleared pass and they've got delicious acorn and they've got water to drink from the pond. So this is, in my opinion, this is where the juice is gonna be for deer. Not an expert, it's my guess. So let's run up top and see if we can find a spot for the first blind and then we'll come back down here and decide where we want the second one. Shoo! All right, folks, I found a way better spot. Okay, I don't know what I scrap that idea. This is the idea. Look at this. So This is, so the camera that I said was at the bottom was actually at the top. So the one that actually had that dead cedar trunk in a lot of the scenes, and I think this was the one that had most of the action, I'm pretty sure, was right here. So the camera was here. So here's that dead tree. So if you guys look back at the pictures I got, this one with the dead tree is right here. So that is the trail. Super skinny, super narrow, goes to those delicious oak trees. But then you come up here, and this is freaking deer paradise. So this is much more open. This makes way more sense for a pew spot. So I think tuck it back here somewhere and basically have it sit to where you can look and you can see deer coming down, because they're going to use this path that I made. Or if they do come from down that way and work their way up, because this is bedding territory here, okay? So this is where, not, this isn't the only bedding spot on my property, but it's definitely a decent one where there's some good grass, but I cut this trail. This is, I wanna turn this into a food plot next year. Take all this grass out, make this entire thing a big giant food plot, and then get one of those tower stands that sits you up there 15 feet, and then you can see everything. And I know there's oak trees down there because I've walked down there before and found oak trees that dropped acorns, and I know that's probably a really good spot to deer hunt down in there. I just haven't explored it enough. And I might explore it today, go buy another third blind and set one up, because my property goes way down in that hill. And that's honestly probably where the big bucks are gonna be. This stand right here is gonna be to see deer, whether they're bucks or does, I don't know. But this, you're gonna get action here. If you sit here, something is gonna cross from this pack to this patch, from that patch down here. Something is gonna be using this trail right here, pretty much guaranteed. Now I didn't set any cameras up right here to see what comes up and down, but being that that camera over there had so much action, it had to have come from one direction or the other. So I don't know if that makes sense. I'm done blabbering. Let's go ahead and get blind number one set up. I think the best spot probably over here, because then that gives you an opportunity to shoot down that valley. So I think hug it against this tree and you get shots that way, and you get all your shots that way. I don't think anything's gonna come right in front. So you're gonna be talking side shot and side shot. And then I'm gonna take some of my chainsaws and chop down some of these smaller cedar and brush this whole thing in to make it look like one big cedar, if that makes sense. I think this is a good spot, because you're gonna be, even if you see a deer there, by the time it sees you, you can shoot it. And from there, you're gonna be able to watch deer walk all the way. That's my theory at least. So let's see how hard this blind is to put together, and let's get to work. The easiest thing ever. That took me 3 minutes and 10 seconds, folks. I timed it because I recorded it, but easy freaking peasy. These are nicer than I thought. I'm pretty sure I got these for like 90 bucks each. They blend in great too. The camo honestly blends in great. I'm gonna need, again, some brushing, but I'm putting them out here so that way the deer can obviously still get used to it. But like, take that little cedar there, a couple of little ones there, and just stick them, just plant them in front. So inside looks like this. So I'm gonna take a couple of these branches down. So this is gonna be the shooting lane to that pasture. I've got a lot of good windows in front. Doesn't do me any good. And then this side one, that's your angle there. Unfortunately, this hole is too far that way. I tried rotating it there, but then you lose that one. And I think this one is more important. I think you're gonna see deer from that way more so than that one. It's a simple fix though. I mean, you just open up one of these sides like this, poke the old pew out there, and you'll be good to go. Wow, I need to go buy a few more of these. These are sick. Super easy, super roomy. You could easily, I mean, it says 3 person, ideally probably 2 beefcake. Blind one set, I think it looks pretty darn good. I could always cut a couple of these limbs off, and really, I might do that. Cut some of these limbs off this tree and kind of tuck it a little bit. I might need to mess with the rotation of it though, but I could always do that. I mean, otherwise it doesn't really look that bad. If you look at it from there, I mean, you can tell clearly there's a blind, but the deer, they'll get used to it. And when you come up here, obviously you just walk in, be quiet, jump in, and hope for the best. So anyways, let's get this guy brushed in. Sorry if that time was a little bit dark. I messed up my camera settings before I hit record, so that's my bad. But look at this. This is a brushed in blind. Now, obviously you can tell, hey, that's a blind, Rick. But these deer, obviously they're gonna get used to it as time goes on, because I'm not planning on hunting for a little while. But look at that side too. It's good. I like it. Again, can you tell it's a blind? Yeah. If I were to cut a hole in these trees, stick it in there, and then brush the whole thing, would it look better? Yes. But I don't wanna do that because I don't know if I'm gonna need to shoot that way. If I knew I wasn't gonna go that way, that's what I would do. I would tuck it way back in there and have a nice long shot that way. But since I've seen so many deer on trail cameras down there, in case they come up here, whether it's morning, evening, to go up here in bed or whatever deer do, deer doing deer things, I want to be versatile and see both. So I think that's plenty good. I think I've seen a lot worse blinds. I mean, you see people with those huge, tall tripod blinds sitting in the middle of a bean field and they shoot deer out of it. Because again, you're using a rifle, so you can get further distance and stuff. So blind number one is complete. I'm going to try to set up a camera out here as well. So that way I get pictures sent to my phone saying, hey, there's deer. That way I know, hey, there's this big buck. I want to shoot him. He comes out every day at 8 a.m. and 7 p.m. And then I know when to come hunt. The cell cameras are absolute game changers. So I'm sweaty though. I mean, look at these dogs are sitting in the shade. It's so hot. It's a hot day today. It's unseasonably hot. Not a good time to be setting up this stuff, but you got to do what you got to do. Obviously, you guys noticed I'm still by myself, still under quarantine. And I put that on it because I am quarantining, but you know, I've gone out and duck hunted and stuff like that, but I'm not with anybody. No one's coming with me. Pool Jet, Banjo, they're all staying home. So I am still under quarantine because I still am technically under the window of having COVID. I have Corona, because you guys are curious. I have it right now, but I don't, you know, I don't have any symptoms, but I'm just following the guidelines as far as how long to stay away from people. So with that being said, blind number one done. Let's go find a spot for blind number two. Shoo! Well, folks, I think I found the optimal crying right out here. Hunting spot here. Okay, I was not planning on putting anything out. I have been putting up cameras as I've been going. Haven't filmed it just because I don't think you guys care that much about getting footage of me sticking a camera to a tree. But I've put a few of them out along my journey. So to give you a reference, the pond is over there. My house is over there. So we're kind of like in between some spots here. We made a trail though. So this trail, if you follow this all the way down, it'll go to our last blind. But it's a way. I would say at least half a mile or so to the blind over there. So there's this beautiful, it looks so good. And I put a camera here. So if you remember earlier in this video, I said this is the furthest east camera. You remember me saying that closest to my house? It was right on that tree. So doesn't that just look so prime for deer? Look at that. It's like a nice little shaded, just a perfect trail right there. I don't, for some reason, I'm not gonna, give me some wood to knock on. Lucy, all right, this is gonna have to do. Knock on wood. If I was to guess, I'm gonna kill a deer. I mean, I feel like I'd kill a deer at the last spot too, but like, I don't know. It just looks so majestic. I don't know what it is about that. It just looks right, okay? I just have this feeling. So we've got that spot, okay? Which is to our what? And then to the east is, like I said, my house, but still not for maybe half mile or so. But we've got this trail that we made right here. So this trail, it leads up and then there's a trail that shoots down, but then you basically just like go over that hill, back up the hill, and then you're at the hill at the top of my house, which I see deer up there all the time. So I know deer come from there. And then it gets better, folks, don't you worry. And then you've got these trails, which I know it doesn't really look like much of a trail, but there's a trail to the left side, and then I made one over on this right side here. And there's not much of a trail now, but you guys get the idea. Basically, there's a path, and what it does is it winds, then it goes up and around, and then it goes across, and then it goes down to the pond. So this is, when we made the building trails video, this was the first trail we made, was this one. So it's a nice little bottom area, obviously super, super thick. I thought about putting a blind down there because it's nice and flat, but I don't know. I haven't put any cameras over there before, so I'm going to go set one out now, but I don't know how many deer actually travel over there. I know a lot of deer travel here though, because I've got my neighbor's property, lots of timber, and I just had a camera over there and it showed me there were some deer. So I think the optimal spot, since these blinds are like, you can shoot out of three sides of it, is to put it right here, right in the middle. So if it's sitting here, obviously I need to brush it in. Boom, you get shot to the east. Boom, you get shot to the northeast, and then boom, you get shot to the west. So you can pretty much hunt. I mean, obviously you're not gonna get anything there, but like if the deer are up towards my house or that side of my property and want to come down here, boom. If they're down by the pond and they come up here, boom. They're to the west and for some reason they want to come over here, boom. Okay, so Lucy, did you set a stick or a bone? Come here, Lucy. Did you get a stick or a bone? What is that guy? Come here, buddy. What you got? Oh, that's a bone. Lucy, hey, look at that guy. I don't know. I'm assuming it's a deer bone. Good job, bud. There you go. She's gonna be a heck of a shot. Hunting dog. Look, she just found that bone somewhere down in the woods. Millie, you let her have that bone. Good job, Lucy. That's a good dog. Anyway, so I need to figure out the exact position. I mean, ideally you would tuck it way back, but then you're gonna lose this shot. So I'm honestly thinking have it stick out a little bit. I could probably keep this tree, because yeah, see, then I lose that shot unless I cut all those limbs off, which I could do that. Or I could poke it out here. See, I'm gonna be sticking out quite a bit though. In order to get that shot, unless I cut these limbs, I'm gonna be sticking out. This tree gives me nice cover for that side though. All right, well, let me do some thinking, and well, you guys just enjoy the time lapse. Yeah! at that guy. I don't know if it's as good as the first one. The first one was pretty tough to beat. Obviously, you know, you still got some bare spots, but at the end of the day, these deer aren't pressured. They're not gonna think anything of it. After the first day of them walking past this thing, they're gonna walk past it every other day and they're gonna think nothing of it. And then your boy's gonna jump in and give it the old pew. But I mean, it's not bad. It took me 20 minutes, in case you guys are curious, to set it up and get it brushed in total. 20 minutes. Again, it's not ideal. I got the bottom really good. The top wasn't that great. This one's different completely. I don't even know how they're, it's literally identical packaging. Oh no, one's 3-person deer blind, one's 3-person clear view mesh deer blind. Got it. This one was different. It was a little bit harder. The other one I could brush in entirely and just leave these little windows, but these big windows go down. And then there's also, I have a lot of viewing. Like the other spot was like one narrow canal and one narrow canal. This one I've got all that. I took down that cedar was there so you could see a little bit more, but I really should take out all those cedars there, because then if a deer comes down, I could shoot from there. But honestly, I'm too lazy to do that. And then I wanted to make sure I could still see there. So if a deer comes down and turns that corner, pew. I feel good about this one. I feel really good about the other one as well. So I am going to set some cameras out and some cell cams and let them rip. Don't check, I mean, check them on my phone, but don't actually go get them until, well, pretty much never. I mean, just leave them even throughout the season. But pretty much at the end of today's video, it wasn't anything too crazy. In case you're curious, Lucy found another bone. So I'm guessing something died. What do you guys think? Oh, it's pretty delicious bones. Organic, huh? Oh yeah, nice. Yep, see, she found this guy right here. Organic bone. I'd say that's probably a deer. Good job, buddy. First, that's your first bone find. She's gonna be a heck of a shed hunting dog come next whatever spring, I guess. So that's pretty much what I've got. We've got two deer blinds now set up. I think they look pretty good. I don't think, like I said, people put those huge tripod ones out and the deer just get used to it. So it is a little bit late taking them out here, I know, but it just kind of happened with the timing of everything. I said I'm still by myself. I was trying to wait until the boys could come help me, but I mean, it took an afternoon. It's not that bad. It took right around 2.5 hours to find the spot, set them up. Like I said, this one was what, 20 minutes. The other one was about 25 minutes, plus the going around, plus the planning, plus setting up some trail cameras. So it really was not as bad as I thought. Like I said, I was planning on waiting for the boys to come help me just to make it go a little bit faster, but we got it done. So with that being said, stay tuned to some deer hunting videos. If you guys have any tips, comment them down below. If you guys saw any spots on my property, you're like, yo, you should have put the blind here instead, let me know. But like I said, you've got some really nice condensed confined trails that I know the deer are using because I put cameras out. So it's just one of those things, like, no, I don't have a food plot to hunt. I do have acorns falling from a tree. That's about all I got going for me. But I'm banking on the trail situation. I'm banking on the movement, which is when you're gonna find bucks. I was doing a ton of research. A lot of people said they don't kill big bucks on food plots because they come out past shooting light hours. You gotta get them on their way to the food plot or on their way to the bedding area. So you have to kind of go upwind or down trail or whatever it might be in order to catch them before they get to it. I found a really good bedding spot way over there that was just to the south of that first blind, like a bedding. I mean, talk about beds. I should have been filming. I didn't even bring the camera down there when I walked down there, but like the whole thing was just grass with beds. So you're gonna wanna catch them going to and from the food source. Supposedly that's when you get the big buck. I'm sure some of you guys are arguing saying that you kill big bucks inside of your food plots every year. That might be so, but I will accept any tips and advice and suggestions you guys have, because I'm an amateur deer hunter, but I'm doing my best. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. We will catch you guys in the next one. And